Hello to everyone, welcome to my channel in mechanical engineering concept. Today I am going to discuss about muff coupling, design procedure of muff coupling. It is a rigid type coupling. It is a part of rigid coupling in which the sleeve or a muff is used to connect input and output shaft. This is the 3D representation of that coupling in which in the input and output shaft there is a keyway, and this is the sleeve or muff which is used to connect this input shaft and output shaft to transmit power. As I discussed earlier in basics of coupling and types of coupling, this is the 2D representation of the muff coupling, or also known as a sleeve coupling, in which small d is the diameter of the shaft, input or output diameter. Here I am assuming that the input and output diameter of shaft is same. Capital L is the length of the sleeve, which is equal to 3.5 times of diameter of the shaft. This section is the key, which is a square type key or a flat key or rectangular key. This capital D is the diameter of this sleeve, which is equal to 2 times of diameter of the shaft plus 13 value. And here I am assuming that the torque transmitted into the shaft is torque generated into the shaft is the MT. So the design procedure of the muff coupling is, so to design a muff couple, we have different steps to follow. First, we need to calculate the diameter of the shaft, by which we can calculate the length of hub, diameter, outer diameter of the sleeve, diameter of the shaft. MT is equal to 60 into 10 to the power 6 kilowatt, 2 pi n by 60. It is a basic relation to calculate torque with the help of power and speed. We can calculate torque, and with the help of torque we can calculate diameter of the shaft with respect to stresses. Tau is the basic relation which has come out from torsional equation T by J tau by R G theta by L. From T by J tau by R, with the help of that relation, we can achieve tau is equal to 16 MT by pi D cube. Here the value of MT we can calculate from this equation, which is the basic power, torque and speed relation. Here I can achieve this MT value, Newton per mm. In problem, we always know what is the basic value of shear stress. With the help of this equation, we can calculate diameter of the shaft. With the help of diameter of shaft, in step B, we can calculate the sleeve dimension. As I told you earlier, the diameter of the outer diameter of the sleeve or muff will be equal to 2 times of diameter of shaft plus 13 mm, or length of the hub will length of the sleeve or muff will be 3.5 times of diameter of shaft. So to check whether this muff or sleeve value is safe enough to bear that torque or load, so we can use the basic torsional equation relation. Here the polar moment of inertia J will be for, we can consider this polar moment of inertia for hollow section, this cylinder, hollow cylinder. Here the small d is the diameter of the shaft, which is inserted in this hollow cylinder, hollow section. Capital D is the outer dia of the shaft, outer dia of the sleeve, which is the outer section of that sleeve or muff. So if the tau will be induced value will be lesser than the permissible value, then the component will be safe, as we know that. In step 3, after the designing the sleeve and the shaft, we need to design the key. Here in a muff coupling, or in we can say that sleeve coupling, basically we use to connect shaft to sleeve square and flat key, basically using. So we know that the width and height for square key is 1/4 times of diameter of the shaft, and for flat key the height is equal to 1/6 times of diameter of the shaft, which is smaller than the width of the key, where the width of key is 1/4 times of diameter of the shaft, and length will be L by 2. L is the length of the sleeve, which is the half for each of the shaft, each one of the shaft, because here half of the length of shaft is connected with the half of the length of sleeve, and remaining half of the length of the shaft will connect with the remaining half of length of the sleeve or hub, or you can say that muff. So due to that, we basically considering L is equal to L by 2, the length of the key is, each shaft is 1/2 of the length of the sleeve. In step D, we need to check whether the width and height of the key is safe enough to bear the torque in the shaft and between sleeve. So we use basic shear stress and compressive stress relation, which I have already derived in the previous lectures. So whether if the permissible stress, permissible shear stress and permissible compressive stress is more than the induced stress, then the component will save. This is the basic checking process, and after that we can say that the key and the shaft are made up of basic plain carbon material, C40, C20, C30, C35, so on and so forth, basic plain carbon steel. And the sleeve or a muff is made up of gray cast iron. Basic grading can be defined as a FG200, where F represents the iron, G represents the gray, and 200 represent the ultimate strength of that material in Newton per mm square or in megapascal. So this is the basic procedure to design a muff coupling or a sleeve coupling. With the help of this procedure, we can calculate the basic geometrical or dimensional value for the muff coupling, design of shaft, design of key and design of sleeve. And we can check with the help of this procedure whether this dimension will safe enough to bear the torque or power or speed to transmit from input shaft to output shaft. I hope you like this video. Then if you like this video, then please press the like button, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, and please, after subscribing my channel, please press the bell icon to get further notification related to my channel videos. And if you have any query, then please tell me in my comment box below this video. Thank you.